Preferences. It's going to be different on Windows. On Mac, they always put preferences in the same place, but it should be option, comma. And then this is, this will bring things up. So you can configure this top, pretty much any, the upper zone or the lower zone, just right click and add whatever you want to see. Windows zone controls. This, if you don't already have your keyboard shortcuts for these, you might want to keep this handy, because these window zones are, they're pretty handy. You may also want to turn on, if you go to this cog here, info line. That's useful for automation and stuff. You'll see that later. And then same thing down here. You can right click, add whatever you want. And that's, it's personal preference, so I'm not going to really tell you how to do that. It's whatever you want to see. It's going to take a little bit of experimentation. You'll get it. This can be important. So like once you have all of your settings the way you like them, you can go to this profile manager, and this will let you save your profile and recall it later if you want to, you know, maybe if you're working at somebody else's place, you want to bring all of your preferences for their Cubase installation. You can do that. Key commands, if you want to learn those or set up your own, that's option K. I put the intro at the end to make it easier to skip. You're welcome. Subscribe if you'd like more stuff like this. This video series is brought to you by my friends on Patreon. If you want to learn more stuff about Cubase, but you're tired of trying to piece together information from random videos with no context to connect them, you may want to check out this playlist that walks you through an entire project from start to finish. This one here. That's right. You got to click on it, though.